Hi, my name is Pavel, I make games, and today we are going to prepare ourselves to not creating a scene transition, but a room transition. We'll work with one unity scene, and inside it we will have two game objects with the whole rooms. And as the player goes to the left or to the right, we set them inactive or active. This method is simpler, but will make your game slower because it needs to load everything at once. In such a small game we won't see any difference, but if you would like to know how to make a real scene transition, check out the top right corner. There should be a link to a video you need. In the scene 1 we will create a new UI image, of course it will be a child object of this canvas. And we're gonna make it a button which lets us go to the next room. Let's make it thin and move it to the right. Okay, now it's time to change its color and the alpha. I think 128 would be fine. And now we need to rename it. It will be go to scene 2. Now let's go, for example, to goal painting and let's not remove but copy this component, I mean event trigger. And let's just paste component as new in go to scene 2. We've saved some time and we may use it to write a new function which changes the room. It will be a public void called check special conditions. By the way, we are in the game manager. And inside we will check if our item ID is something, then if it is, we will go to scene 1, and if it's something else, we will go to scene 2, and if it's something else, we win the game. To do this we will need an item data for sure. As I look at it now, I think it's a great occasion to encourage you to take up a challenge and try to write this function on your own. Of course it's mainly for the people who watch this tutorial series from the beginning and want to improve their skill. Good luck, have fun, and in a moment you will see me doing it. As you can see, there is a switch case which checks what's the value of item.itemid. By the way, it's in item data which we created a few episodes ago. If the item ID is -11, we go to the scene 1. And we break it because we don't want to check any other values. If it's not -11, then we check if it's -12. If it is, we go to scene 2. Then we break it because again there is no need to check any other cases. The last case which does something is -1. If that's the value of item ID, we win the game. If you've watched previous episodes, which I highly recommend you to do, you may wonder why do we use -1 here to win the game and -1 in the click manager to tell Unity that we don't need any other items to pick a given item up. If you think so, you are terribly wrong, my friend, because that was required item ID. I tell you that to make sure that you know what's going on there. Anyway, now we need one more coroutine, and this time it will be a public IEnumerator change scene. There we will need an integer number, which will be our scene number, and also some kind of delay, which will be a float type variable. First we need a safety line to make sure that this won't break. And at the beginning we need to do something to make the screen go black and disable clicking. At the end of this coroutine we show the new scene and enable clicking. In the middle, I don't know for now, let's just write something general like beep boop scene changing stuff. Okay, let's copy this part and let's use it over there in check special conditions. We'll need to start this coroutine, so let's write it and use what we've just copied and let's use 1 as a scene number and 0 as a delay. Now let's do the same with the case minus 12 and scene number 2. As it comes to winning the game, we'll need a number 3 and let's say delay 1. For now the delay doesn't make any difference, but I want you to know that we will use it in the future. And now we need to think about where to call this function. And I think the click manager would be the best option after we update scene after action. So we wait until the player stops walking, and because this item we click on won't be pickable, we need to paste this new line in else statement. Because it's from the game manager, let's use it over there. And we need to give this function a item. For now we're gonna use a debug.log to print a message, and I think we are done, so let's go to the Unity and see what happens. Before we start playing, we will need a new empty game object. Let's name it go to scene 2. Move it a little bit higher and add a new component there. It will be an item data. Here we need something negative as a required item, but don't use minus 1. That's a special number for the items you can always pick up, and we want to make sure that we cannot pick the item up no matter what. The item ID needs to be minus 12 because we want to go to room number 2. Now let's see what do we need here. We need a go-to point. So let's create one. Let's name it go to point, and let's move it somewhere outside the game screen. As it comes to the hint message, it will be still there, but the player will be outside of the camera's view, so we just need to make sure that it will be small enough to not be visible. We also don't need to give it any name, and we need to attach a go to point here. Alright, now we need to go to this black bar. First we need to rename it because it's not like the others, and use item data from go to scene to object. It's not necessary, but since we don't use names, we may remove those two elements. Okay, and now as we play the game, we can click on this black bar and we get a test message. That's great! Now let's deal with this screen going black as we change scenes. We'll need a new UI canvas. I think for the first time in this tutorial, we will leave this as it is. Now let's add a new UI image there. And click this icon, and holding Alt key, let's just make it cover up the whole screen. Now we need to change its color to black and reduce its alpha to 0. Now we can't see it, but because it's enabled and because this render mode is set to overlay, it's on top of everything, so we can't click anything. Let's test that out. Alright, and to make sure that it will still work even if we make a silly mistake somewhere, let's increase this sort order. Now we may disable this image and go to our code. First we need to add to our game manager a public image called blocking image. Now we need to scroll down to the change scene coroutine. And here we will need a while loop, which will make our screen go black. Inside we will check if our blocking image.color.alpha is less than 1, and if it is, we will increase it. 1 is the maximum value, so eventually we will reach the no opacity state. We may copy that and use it again to make the screen visible again. Now we will check if our alpha is bigger than 0, and we will decrease it. We will need a new variable of type color, and it will be the same color as the blocking image color. In this while loop, we will increase its alpha by, let's make it simple, just a time dot delta time. That means we will always make this screen go black in around 1 second. Anyway, now we need this blocking image dot color to be the same as C. We have to deal with this additional variable because we need to modify the whole color, not just the alpha of it. If we use a separated color type variable, we can access its alpha and use the whole color as a color of something. Let's just write it as we would do if we could, and we get an error here. Well, it's not helpful that it is in Polish, but just trust me, it is related to what I said. So that's worth to remember that we need to change the whole color, not just the alpha. Okay, now we may copy that and paste it over there and change this plus to minus. I forgot to tell you that we need to wait one frame every time we increase or decrease this alpha because we want it to be an animation. Alright, let's see what we need to change the scene. We need to hide or disable the old one, show the new one, teleport the player and save the number of the current scene. In the future, we will also need to reset the animations. And to help you out, I will tell you that we will use an array of game objects called local scenes, where all of our scenes will be. And now, as you may guess, please do as much of it as you can, you will learn a lot by doing so, and in the next episode I will show you how I did it. Have a good day and see you soon!